kanatong tanan nga niya karon dinhi sulod sa Pilgrim Center sa Basilica Minore del Santo Niño, og usab ninyo mga igsoon nga uban kanamo karon ining misa pinaagi sa online o sa ubang paagi sa social media platforms. Kanatong tanan, Peace Señor! Viva Señor Santo Niño!
Viva Señor Santo Niño!
Much as we would like the acclamations, Peace Señor, Viva Señor Santo Niño to be heard everywhere, we want it first to sound genuine within ourselves. We need the devotion to be rooted in its origins. So, I invite you, brothers and sisters, to bear with me as we take a quick historical music. Those special moments of peace and faith during the baptism of our ancestors as Christians on April 14, 1521 in Cebu, and the discovery of the image of Santo Niño. The arrival and stay of the Magellan expedition in Cebu were generally peaceful and successful up to a point later. Relying on his Malay servant Enrique, the interpreter, Magellan succeeded in convincing the paramount chief of Cebu, Raja Humabon, to receive Christian baptism, which he did together with his ally Datos and followers. It was the morning of April 14, 1521, and the minister was the chaplain of the fleet, Father Pedro de Valderrama. Antonio Pigafetta, the expedition's chronicler, wrote that after the mass, Magellan and Humabon walked together to the shore, and before parting ways, their men embraced each other. Was it a show of brotherhood and peace? What kind of peace? Rather than conclude, we should instead question ourselves that a sweet act without pure motive could later sour, just as the remaining men of Magellan would taste at the hands of the Cebuanos days later. In the afternoon, Humabon's wife arrived at the chapel to receive baptism. When shown three religious images, the yet unbaptized queen was attracted to the small statue of the baby Jesus, the Santo Niño. She held it, gazed at its gentle, peaceful, and lovely face, and wanted it as a gift. Queen Juana did not receive it right after her baptism, but kept the desire in her heart. Days later, she returned to the chapel to hear Mass. There, she received her gift, the statue of the Santo Niño. It is tempting on our part to ask what happened at the first moment of her encounter with the statue of the Santo Niño. Was it faith born from that inner peaceful encounter with Christ? We can only assume, but I think it would not be a stretch to say that the meaning of the words Batubalani sa gugma sa daang tao palangga was conceived at that moment. The queen was easily drawn to the image of the child Jesus because it is irresistibly attractive. So dili ta kaingon nga diha natao dayon ang iyahang gugma sa maong image, kundi let us just say, and enough to say, nga nadani siya o unsay nakapadani niya, maunay dako kaayo nga ingon tampo nga grasya sa Dios. Ako bitaw, one time sa dihang dihay nobena sa Talisay, Talisay nun man ko, nobena para sa piyesta sa amo ang patrona Santa Teresa, bata pa ko, 7 anyos, gidako sa kung iyaan simbahan. Pag-abot na mo simbahan, atubangan simbahan, daghan kayong baligya. Naghan kayong mga duanan. But I don't know why, dito man ko na-attracted sa imahe ni Santo Niño. Gamay nga imahe ni Santo Niño, nagpapalit ko sa akong tiya. Unya to, gipalitan ko. Naaman tayo mga unsariha mga baligya, nga mga duanan, ang Santo Niño mag akong giganahan, niya akong gibutang sa ako ang amusang altar nga gamay. E bata pa ko, nagsigi na ko o ampo ni Santo Niño. Hangtod nga, nadako ko. I won't consider it as a devotion because I was just a little child. I was just attracted to the image. But sa dihang nag-college na ko, nag-eskwela ko sa syudad, mag-anhian ako Santo Niño every Friday. So mao na to'y klarong debosyon kay may edad naman ko. So it started with the attraction. Then the devotion followed. Mao na nga dinhin ako. Hangtod after a year, nisod kog seminary. Pag adto na ko seminaryo, maugi akong sangpiton kanunay, Santo Niño. Akong gabay sa akong kinabuhi nga nangayo ko niya nga mapari ko. Si Santo Niño nga mahal nga Birhen Maria, mo'y kanunay na akong sangpiton sa akong pag-istudyo sa seminaryo. Hangtod nga gipari ko, gigasahan ko ni Santo Niño nga napari ko, ugwa lang gani ihibaw-i, iyapag yung gipakapinan, gihimo pa kong obispo. Mao nang masipang pakpak ni Santo Niño. Kununsa man ko gasa ni Santo Niño alang kanako, gasa alang kanato, nakatawhan sa Dios, ilabi na kanatong subuanon. Masipang pakpak usab alang sa tanan. O pa kumahuman ha? Going back to the historical musing, 44 years after the Magellan expedition, the Spaniards returned to Cebu and invaded the settlement. A small statue of the Santo Niño was found in an unburned house. It was believed to be the same one given by Magellan to the Queen of Cebu. Days after the image was discovered by the Spaniards, the natives made various attempts to take it back. Failing that, they asked to be allowed to see it peacefully. Legazpi saw this as an opportunity to convince the natives to formally make peace with him. On Thanksgiving Day, he invited the Datos to attend under his protection, and several came. In a solemn procession, the image was displayed for the first time since its finding and brought to the church of the Spanish settlement. That day, Christians and pagans venerated the Santo Niño. On June 4, 1565, formal peace between the Spaniards and Cebuanos was made. There was peace. But what kind of peace was established? From these short clips of history, we can see, brothers and sisters, how the image of the Santo Niño became instrumental in forging unity and peace among peoples. We see that a common devotion helps bring individuals to join the community in its journey of faith. However, in history, it is hard to conclude what were the motives behind the established unity and peace between the Spaniards and the natives through the Santo Niño. Was it mere political peace, to tolerate and respect the other for the sake of the particular interest of the individual or group? Was it only external peace, the absence of war, violence, and conflict? It reminds us, brothers and sisters, that when people come together to honor the Holy Child, the Holy Childhood of Christ, the desire for unity, for peace, should be paramount together with one's own intentions. Depending on the motives, peace now may be classified as either the peace of this world or the peace of the Lord. But for us Christians, we know well that genuine peace can only be found in Christ, and His peace is not the same as this world's peace. Amen?
Amen.
We therefore further clarify our stand as devotees. The Santo Niño is not just the source of peace, but the source of true peace in our walk of faith. Just as the Spaniards and the natives were united in peace through the magnet of the Santo Niño, all of us here are also united tonight by the same magnet of love. But I hope and pray that what differs us from history is that our unity and peace cannot be reduced into sheer political peace or any other external peace defined by this world. Our unity in peace is born out of that full and confident trust in Christ through the Santo Niño. Nagkatapo kita karon dili tungod lamang sa atong personal nga mga interest, kundili nadani kita niining batubalani sa gugma ug kalinaw, pinaagi sa iyang kalinaw, kita usab nakabato niini tungod sa atong laom nga pagsalig sa Dios, nga ubanan gayud kita niya sa atong panaw sa kinabuhi. Ang kalinaw nga gikan sa Dios, maangkon lamang nato diha sa atong tinud-anay nga pagsalig sa iyahang pulong. Ang pagsalig sa iyang pulong maoy maghatod ka nato dili lang sa kalinaw kundili sa kalipay o katagbawan sa tuang kinabuhi. Ang dili pagsalig sa iyang pulong maoy magpalutaw sa tuang mga kabalaka, mga kahadlok, o ang atong mga kabalaka o kahadlok maoy magtukmod o magguyod ka nato ngadto Hinuon sa dili maayo nga kahintang sa panglawas. Mao nga uban Hinuon masakit tungod sa sobrang kabalaka, kahadlok. Mao nga niining atong piyesta Senior, gitawag kita sa pagsalig ngadto kang Santo Niño. Salig sa Dios, salig sa iyang pulong. Mao nga dihay asawa, ningon siya sa pari nga padre, dili naman ko pa simbahon sa akong bana, oy. Kay lagi, sige lang kuno kong simba, wanay nung pinahimos balay. Ingon ang pari, simba lang. Ayaw kahadlok, anang mga hulga sa imong bana. Pagkasunod Domingo, nibalik siya. Ingon siya nga padre, lisod-lisod na gining hulga sa kong bana. Ingon siya, og musimba pa ko, iyaha kuno kong patyon. Ingon ang pari, ayaw kahadlok, salig sa Dios, isalig ang tanan sa Dios. Pagkasunod Domingo, nibalik na sad ang mga babae, niingon siya nga, padre, og musimba pagani ko, ingon akong bana, apilon ka niya patay, ingon siya, ay, nagsimba. Dali ara na usapoy. Mao na nga, kung tinud-anay atong pagsalig sa Dios, siguro ko nga, maangkon gayod nato ang kalinaw gikan kaniya. Mao kini ang atong tema, Santo Niño, our source of peace in the walk of faith. Busa kitang tanan sa atong tagsa-tagsa ka mga katuyuan, mga problema, bisan unsay problema, kwarta, trabaho, relasyon, sakit, balatian, mga pag-antos, ingon man sa atong mga pangandoy sa kinabuhi, atong ipadangat kining tanan ngadto sa batang Hesus nga puno sa pagsalig. Pagsalig kaniya og sa iyang pulong. Diha lamang kaniya makabaton kita og tinuod nga kalinaw kahiusa tungod sa tong dakong pagsalig kaniya. May the true peace of the Santo Niño bring us all closer to Him in trust, so that we can all shout with more confidence and conviction, Viva Señor Santo Niño! Viva Señor Santo Niño! Masibang pakpak ka Señor Santo Niño. Please all stand.